Hello guys, and welcome back to another video from Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. In this video, we are going to proceed in our discussion of different phylums which are present in animal kingdom. In the last video, we have talked about Polyphera. So in this video, we are going to talk about the next phylum, that is Coelenterata, which is also known as Cnidaria. So firstly, each and every phylum has some important peculiar characteristics which will only be found in that phylum. For example, in sponges or in Polyphera, we had water canal system. Similarly, the Coelenterata will be also having some sort of peculiar features, and that feature is the cnidocyte or the cnidoblast. As the name indicates, Cnidaria. So that nid, C-N-I-D, nid word is taken from cnidocyte or cnidoblast cells. Okay, so cnidoblast or cnidocytes are the peculiar feature. Koi agar pooch le ki aisi kya cheez hai jo sirf Coelenterata में ही प्रेजेंट है, तो वो ये है नीडोसाइट्स, राइट. सो नीडोब्लास्ट और नीडोसाइट्स कंटेन्स नेमेटोसिस्ट, ओके, नेमेटोसिस्ट और नेमेटोसाइट्स और स्टिंगिंग सेल्स. अब इनका काम क्या रहता है? दीज आर सम बल्ब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर. आप लोग एनसीईआरटी में डायग्राम देखेंगे. इट डू हैव द फंक्शन ऑफ एनकरेजमेंट, ओके, इफ द Coelenterate वॉन्ट इट्सेल्फ और इट्स बॉडी टू अटैच टू सम सरफेस, देन He will sting that thing. That's why it is known as stinging cell. क्या करेगा? उसके पास एक औजार जैसी चीज होगी जो कि वो फेंक के मारेगा और सीधा निशाने पर तीर मारकर वहां पर पहुंच जाएगा for encouragement. Okay? So it helps in the encouragement or attachment. After that, the defense. Whenever some organism will come closer to the Coelenterate and if the Coelenterate will recognize कि हाँ यार ये दुश्मन है, इसको तो मारना जरूरी है. If the Coelenterate will recognize that yes, the organism in front of me is my enemy, then he will surely push that thing outside. That is known as nematocyte. So he will put that nematocyte on some other organism's body that will be having some toxins. और वो toxin जाके उस इंसान को या फिर उस particular organism को घायल कर देंगे. So it also provides defense. And after that, there is prey capture. So what is the structure? The structure will be like this. Okay, there will be a thing like that which is known as lasso. Okay, so whenever the Coelenterate will recognize that yes, there is some enemy or it want to encourage or there is some capturing of prey, then it will throw this thing outside. Okay, like this, it will throw this. That's why it is the stinging cell. उस चीज को फेंक के मारेगा और सामने वाले ऑर्गेनिज्म को क्या करेगा, घायल कर देगा और कैप्चर को भी सिमिलरली प्रे को पकड़ सकता है. ओके, सो दीज आर द फंक्शंस. दिस इज द पेक्यूलियर फीचर, द मोस्ट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर ऑफ Cnidaria. आफ्टर दैट दे आर मोस्टली मैराइन. दे आर ऑब्वियसली एक्वेटिक, एंड एक्वेटिक में भी अगर पूछा जाए वेदर दे आर फ्रेश और मैराइन वॉटर ऑर्गेनिजम्स, देन दे आर मोस्टली मैराइन. सम ऑफ देम आर सेसाइल and some of them can be actively moving. Okay, sessile का मतलब होता है वो चीज जो freely move नहीं कर सकती, and freely moving obviously some things which can move. So they can be sessile, they can be freely moving, and they are mostly aquatic and marine water animals. After that, if we will talk about symmetry, then there are only three phyla which possess radially symmetrical condition. That is Coelenterata, Ctenophora and adult echinoderms, which is an exception. So radially symmetrical इसके बारे में काफी बार बात हो चुकी है. This is the characteristic feature, that is the cnidocyte or cnidoblast, which will contain the nematoblast on the tentacles. Okay, जो body के tentacles होंगे उनके ऊपर ये सारा का सारा जो है काम था present होता है. उन tentacles से ये जो string है ये फेंक के मारी जाती है और सामने वाले organism को क्या किया जाता है, घायल कर दिया जाता है. So this is also a mode of defense. This can also be helping in the capturing of prey, and it is obviously very important for the encouragement of the body of Coelenterate to some substratum. After that, the tissue level organization is present. The only animal phylum with cellular level of organization was Polyphera, जो कि हम पढ़ चुके हैं. After that, all of them will be having tissue or organ or organ system. So tissue level organization is present. Before Platyhelminthus, all of the animals are having two germ layers, that is ectoderm and endoderm, so they are diploblastic. Blighty helminthus and all the other higher animals are having three germ layers, that is ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. These are known as triploblastic. So, in this case, obviously diploblastic condition hogi. Ab, yahan par ek layer maine batai thi, undifferentiated cell layer known as mesoglia. That is also very important. Okay, mesoglia is present. Okay, in place of mesoderm. Kyunki mesoderm agar hoti to ye triploblastic ho jate. Lekin mesoderm nahi hai, uski jagah par undifferentiated cell layer hai, that is known as mesoglia. The digestion is both. Both simply means intracellular and extracellular. I have told you in the last video of porifera, I am also revising porifera so that you can relate ki bhai kya ho raha hai. So porifera mein humne padha tha intracellular digestion. In this there can be intracellular digestion, that is within the cell, and extracellular digestion, that can be outside the cell. I have also made a trick to memorize intracellular or extracellular digestion. So I'll be posting that trick in the next video so that you can memorize all the characters just by 2-3 words. You just have to memorize 2-3 words and after that you can do all the questions related to a single character. Just like we have done for fertilization. Internal or external fertilization ke liye jaise trick banai hai, similarly hum digestion ke liye bhi bana sakte hain, aur similarly unisexuality or disexuality ke liye bhi bana sakte hain, which is going to be very important. Kyunki wahan se question zipper mein aur NEET mein har saal uthta hai, right? After that, in the last video we talked about the water canal system. There are ostia, okay? Then there is a body cavity, that is spongocoel, and there is osculum. Similarly, there is also another body cavity in case of coelenterate. This is in the porifera. In coelenterate, there is gastrovascular cavity. Gastrovascular cavity hoti hai, and there is single opening, that is mouth. So the alimentary canal is incomplete because there is only single opening. In the complete alimentary canal, there are two different openings. One will be behaving as mouth, another one will be behaving as anus. But in this case, the single opening is present which will do both the functions. So, it is incomplete digestive system, right? Or we can say incomplete alimentary canal. Okay, so all these things are very, very essential for examination. So, kya hota hai? Gastrovascular cavity is the central body cavity in case of coelenterata. This can be the direct question, right? And spongocoel is in the case of porifera. The mouth is present on the hypostome. Hypostome means body ka wo part jo ki exposed rehta hai, jahan par mostly mouth present rehta hai. This arena is our hypostome. Okay, to sabse aage wala part rehta hai, that usually, okay, in most of the cases it is known as the hypostome. So, hypostome ke upar kya rehta hai? Mouth present rehta hai. Right, and that mouth is the only opening, single opening hai. So blind side body plan yahan par paya jayega. After that, there are different kind of examples that are known as corals. Now corals has a very important thing, that they have their skeletal made up of calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate ka skeleton yahan par paya jata hai, which is very rigid, which is very tough. Okay, so they are found as deposits. Coral reef ke baare mein agar aapne suna ho to pure ke pure islands hai yaar. They are so large in size that they used to form islands. Okay, I hope that you have heard about the Great Barrier Reef. It is so large that it is up to certain kilometers. It is a separate island which is only made up of such organisms known as corals, which are made up of calcium carbonate. So yeah, corals is a very interesting thing. I think you must learn about it. Aap logon ko dekhna chahiye corals ke baare mein, bahut maza aayega. After that, there can be two different type of body plans which are present in the coelenterates. The one is polyp and the other is medusa. Now, what are polyps? What are medusa? Polyps are sessile. It means that they cannot move freely and they are cylindrical, right? So, sessile, cylindrical organisms. Just like that, obviously its shape dekho yaar, this must be sessile and this is having umbrella shape, so it must be actively moving. So medusa is umbrella shape and it is actively moving. So these are the major differences between polyp and medusa. Polyp is cylindrical shape, it is sessile. Medusa is umbrella shape and it is actively moving. After that, this and this can be interconverted. Kya hota hai, kuch organisms they are only polyp and some organisms are only medusa. But in some exceptional cases, the polyp can be converted into medusa, the medusa can be converted into polyp. And this particular phenomena is known as metagenesis. This is very important. This is the most important point from this article. What is metagenesis? The interconversion of two different forms, two different body forms into each other is known as metagenesis. For example, the most important example is Obelia. Obelia mein metagenesis hoti hai, where the medusa will be converting into polyp sexually and the polyp will be converting itself into medusa asexually. So, koi pooch le, which of the body forms of Coelenterata is sexually reproducing? Medusa. And which of the following body, structure is asexually reproducing? It will be polyp. So, polyp will be converting itself into medusa asexually, but the medusa will convert itself into polyp sexually. And this interconversion is known as metagenesis, and the most important example is Obelia. Right? And some other examples are Aurelia or jellyfish, which are the medusa, and Hydra and Adamsia are the polyp. So, Hydra, we know very well that there is budding in Hydra. Hydra mein hum bahut commonly padhte hain, and it is a kind of asexual reproduction. Right? So, you can easily learn that Hydra is a polyp and Hydra reproduces asexually. So, polyp is asexual. So, zahir si baat hai, medusa kaisa hua? Sexual. It is that easy. You have to relate the things very well. Okay? So, let's revise the lecture once more so that you can get the most important point. The most important points are the nidoblast or the nidocytes, which will be containing the nematocytes or stinging capsules or stinging cells. Theek hai? Wo cheeze kya karengi? Defense, capturing of prey and encouragement. After that, the metagenesis is very important. Okay? The polyp will convert itself into medusa asexually. The medusa will convert into polyp sexually. And the example of metagenesis is Obelia. Okay? So, this is all about Coelenterata. I hope you enjoyed the lecture very well and I hope you got the concept very well. You don't have to get confused between this one. I'll be providing a trick by which you can memorize all the different examples and all the different characters and you can easily answer them in your examination. So, thank you so much guys for watching this video. If you really like this video, then hit like button, subscribe to my channel for sure and press the bell icon. Thank you so much.